Thank you for this moment. Thank you for the privilege once again for us to come together. Mm-hmm. Come and receive the best you have for us today. Mm-hmm. Heavenly Father, we are asking you, God, that in your mercy and your power, you will minister to us.
Amen.
God, you will meet us at the very point of our need.
Amen.
Holy Spirit of God, you know our present needs, you know our expectations and requests. I pray again, the Father, you will visit us accordingly in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Blessed Holy Spirit, have your way now.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, because of my Father's prayer.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, O my soul. Uh-huh. And all that is within me, praise His holy name. Praise the Lord and forget not all His benefits. So he let all that to me. All forgiveness of the iniquity. I want to open our mouth at this time and begin to appreciate the Lord.
We thank you, Lord, because of whom you are. Almighty Father, we glorify your name. Almighty Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because of who you continue to be.
God, that's the name of praise.
Almighty Father, we praise
for goodness and for His wonderful work. We thank you, Lord. Children of men, let's appreciate Him for the goodness.
We thank you, Lord, because of your goodness. We thank you, Lord, because of your wonder.
Nevertheless, the counsel of God was
Almighty Father, we worship
you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we worship you.
Almighty
Father, we worship you. Because your name is
the God of the
Lord. But nevertheless, the counsel of God was God,
Father, we praise you. We thank you, Lord, because of your faithfulness.
Amen.
Yeah, the Bible says, faith individual for themselves and to the flock over the which the Holy Ghost has made you appear in the sense of God, which he has portrayed in the young blood. We want to thank the Lord because this year the church of the living God will experience growth.
The power of the Lord Jesus Christ. Our church will experience growth in Jesus. Oh, mighty Father, you have to suffer. The power of the Lord Jesus Christ.
We have to suffer.
Amen.
Oh, my God, we pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Pray for everybody in the church. The power and the blood of Jesus Christ. We will receive from the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, you will bless everybody. You will bless individuals. You will bless everyone of us by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. We will receive the power of Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we will shower in the adults, the young, the children, the women, the men, every one of us. Almighty Father, pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. You will baptize us with the Spirit of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Your fire will come upon everybody in the name of Jesus Christ. Your fire will come upon everybody in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, we are going to be baptized with the Spirit of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. O Lord, baptize us. King of kings, baptize us. Almighty Father, baptize us. Almighty Father, baptize us. King of kings, baptize us. Lord of lords, baptize us. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, we pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Spirit of Holy Ghost, that fall upon everyone of us in the name of Jesus Christ. So we shall see God in new dimension. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we shall see God in the new dimension. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we shall see God in the new dimension. You empower us with the Spirit of Holy Ghost, O Lord. You empower us with the Spirit of Holy Ghost, O Lord. You empower us with the Spirit of Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. So much Father, pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. For me, to all the members of the church, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, Lord, you shall send down your fire upon everyone of us in Jesus' name. You shall send down your power upon individual of us in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, mighty Father, pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. The fire of Holy Ghost shall come upon everyone of us in the name of Jesus Christ. Upon everyone of us in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, mighty Father, pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Power from above. Power from above. Power from above. Oh, mighty Father, you will send it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. By the time I get to the pulpit, by the time I'm preaching, Almighty Father, Almighty Father, Almighty God, it will not be me, but it will be the power of, it will be your power in the name of Jesus Christ. People that listen to me, people that listen to members, people that really decide the scripture leader, people that listen to everybody that comes to the pulpit, they will see you, they will see nobody but Holy Spirit, Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
We want to pray that this year, every minister in front of you, every pastor in front of you, every worker in front of you, every leader there, will catch the fire of the Holy Ghost as a roar in the strength of the fire. Jesus.
Amen. Almighty Father, pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, the fire that is burning from the inner fire, Almighty Father, that consumes sin, that pray the word of the Lord, that interpret the word of the Lord. Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. You are going to be unto me now in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to go to every leader in the church in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ upon the women, upon the men, upon everybody of us. Power, you are going to send your power of Holy Ghost upon us in Jesus' name. You are going to send your power of Holy Ghost upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Power from above. Power from above. Power from above. Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. You are going to send it upon everyone of us in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. We request for your power. We request for your anointing. We request for your glory. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ.
Women like Dorcas, to cast Dorcas in the New Testament, oh God. Raise up women with the fire and mercy of the Holy Ghost in the church of God in front of you. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Almighty, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. People like Deborah. Almighty, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. They are going to raise them in the church of God in Charlotte in Jesus' name. Almighty, Father, I pray by the power and the blood. People like Deborah, they are conquered for Israel. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. They are going to raise them in the church, in the church of God of Charlotte in Jesus' name. In the Parallel Bible Church of Charlotte, all our women, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, Almighty Father, you are going to raise them. You are going to raise them above beyond opportunity, above beyond expectation. Almighty Father, I bring my wife before you. I bring Mrs. Kefa before you. I bring Sister Priscilla before you. All of them, Almighty Father, you are going to use them mightily for the Charlotte Church in the name of Jesus Christ. You will send your power upon them. You will send your power upon them. You will send your power upon them. You are going to send your power upon them. You are going to send your power upon them by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. You are going to send your power. You are going to send your power upon every one of them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Our family altars will be on fire. Our family altars will be on fire in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We want to pray that God of heaven will protect every altar. May the fire of the Holy Ghost. The Lord will fight every altar. Every brother in Jesus. Every brother in the thought of God in front of me. Oh Lord, baptize them with the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
Amen. Oh my God, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Start from my house. Start from me. Start from my children. Start from my wife. Oh Lord, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Every altar of individual member in the house, Almighty Father, they will be full of the fire of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. They will be full of the fire of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, in every house, in every member house, in every leader house, in everybody house, in the parliament house,
crucify the flesh forever. Father, we live only for you. Strengthen us in our household. Father, strengthen us.
Our household will be full of Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Full of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Our household will be full of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. And you are going to go to Father. You are going to bless us. You are going to bless our home. You are going to bless us. Father, because I know so much for that is going to be in the name of Jesus Christ. So much for the power and the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are going to do for us in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to do for us in Jesus Christ.
We'll share your word
forever. Amen.
Jesus told us, when the Holy Ghost comes, when the Spirit of truth comes, when the Spirit of the Father, the promise of the Father, when it comes upon us, that's when our lives will be changed. We want to pray, oh Lord, this is the prayer life of every one of the thoughts in some of me, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Baptize the church with the spirit of prayer.
We will be full of the power of prayer in Jesus' name. My life will be full of power of prayer. The life of my wife will be full of life of prayer. The life of Brother Benjamin family will be full of life of prayer. The life of Brother Stephen family will be full of life of prayer. My own family will be full of life of prayer. Oh, my Father, individual in the Deeper Bible Church of Chalopi, our life will be full of life of prayer in Jesus' name. So we empower up with the power of prayer. In the night we will be full of prayer. In the afternoon we will be full of prayer. In the morning we will be full of prayer. We pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. We are going to empower up with the power of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, before we kneel down, we will see God. As we are kneel down, we will see God. And before we open our mouth, we will talk to God. By the time we are opening our mouth, we are talking to God. Almighty Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. This you are going to do for us in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ. This you are going to do for us in the name of Jesus Christ. This you are going to do for us in the name of Jesus Christ. This you are going to do for us in the name of Jesus Christ. We will be full of power of prayer. 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 We individually will be full of power of prayer. Almighty Father, you will empower us with the spirit of prayer in Jesus' name. We will empower us with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. We will empower us with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. We will empower us with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, you will empower us. King of Kings, you will empower us. Almighty Father, you will empower us. Lord of Lords, you will empower us. Amen.
When the fire fell, it is your pillar, when the fire fell, Elijah said, oh God, that these people must know, they may know that there was God in heaven. That God in heaven. There was God in heaven. And then he said, let the fire fall, let the fire of God fall, or the water will dry up. The water became fire. The water became petrol. The water became another thing. The care, you know, now to pray, oh God, every lukewarmness, every lethargy, every coldness, every prayerlessness, every struggle to do the service of God is because of prayerlessness. And we want to pray that today the fire of prayer will consume him in Jesus' name.
Amen. Oh, my Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Everything, every circumstances, everything, every leprosy in my prayer, everything, every wayward in my prayer, everything that not let me able to call upon the name of the Lord as I need to. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. I come against it in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you empower me with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. The power of the blood of Jesus Christ, and be empowered with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. In my place of work, in my house, in every area of my life, by the mighty power, I pray by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. You empower me with the spirit of prayer in Jesus' name. You empower me with the spirit of prayer in Jesus' name. You empower me with the spirit of prayer in Jesus' name. Oh, my God, I pray by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. And empower me with the spirit of prayer. And empower me with the spirit of prayer. And empower me with the spirit of prayer. Oh, my God, I empower me with the spirit of prayer. In continuing, I empower me with the spirit of prayer. And then, oh, my God, I empower me with the spirit of prayer. Lord, I pray by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. You empower me with the spirit of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. On the church, oh, my God, on my family, on my own development area, in every area I find myself. Oh, mighty Father, the power of prayer to be able to bring what out of the problem, to be able to bring my problem, my family out of the problem, to be able to bring everything concerning me out of the problem, to be able to bless the house of the Lord. Oh, mighty Father, the power of prayer, that you pour it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. That the power and the blood of you pour it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. King of Kings, you pour it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord of Lords, you pour it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Abundantly, Father, you pour it upon me in the name of Jesus Christ. King of Kings, you pour it upon me. Lord of Lords, you pour it upon me. Oh, mighty Father, you pour it upon me. Oh, mighty Lord, you pour it upon me. King of Kings. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We want to agree together. We want to pray in the life of anyone. Everyone in that church, whatever the devil has dropped into their life because of anything, whatever Satan has dropped in their life in the past, to some people it's different. To some people it's not moving on to anybody. To some of you, some person, people, it's so many problems because of where let's bless. We want to pray today. Whatever the devil has done, whatever the devil has deposited into the body of it.
You have $4.51 remaining in your account. Please enter the telephone number you wish to dial now, or press *0 to recharge and hear the main menu options.
Hello?
Hello, sir.
Hi, madam. Yeah, I think the pastor one was called, so
okay.
We want to try to reconnect him.
So just continue, Brother Benjamin, to lead. So I will join.
Okay. Let us continue to pray. Let us pray for our country. Let us pray for our country, the U.S., and let's pray for our country, Nigeria. Let's pray for our leaders, because the Word of God has told us that we should pray for our leaders. We've seen the services that is going to come, the prayers that will come from the pulpit, the word of our Father in heaven that will come straight, that will come to meet the needs. Today here around the world, people decide not to preach properly. People are afraid to say the right thing. People want to say what members want to hear. People want to say things to keep our brethren in the house of the Lord. But let us pray that the message that will come this Sunday, that the prayer that will come this Sunday, that will come from our Father in heaven, that our Father in heaven will use his children that are going to preach this Sunday as vessels. Let us pray.
Almighty Father, we pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ that the message that shall come from the pulpit this Sunday shall be direct from Almighty God in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, we pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. It will not be by flesh, it will not be by any, it will not be by self will, it will not be by experience, but it will be by the Spirit of the Lord Himself in the name of Jesus Christ. That from the pastor to the choir to the scripture leader to everyone of us that is going to lead one portion or the other of the program, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, Almighty Father, you will lead in Jesus' name. King of Kings, you are going to lead in Jesus' name. Almighty Lord, you are going to lead in the name of Jesus' name. You will take total control of the. Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let us pray for our brother and pastor in Nigeria who has been leading this prayer. Session. Let us pray that our Father in heaven will continue to strengthen him.
Amen.
And our Lord in heaven, as he is sowing, he is sowing financially, he is sowing physically, he is sowing with his time that many now is late in Nigeria that will be sleeping, but he has decided to follow our Father in heaven. That our Father in heaven will reward him bountifully.
Amen.
Because even Paul has said, if you sow sparingly, you will reap sparingly. If you sow with a bad seed, you will reap nothing. But he has decided to sow bountifully. He has also decided to sow with a good seed. Let the Father in heaven enrich him. Let us pray for him.
And I've been leading from Nigeria. You pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, mighty Father, we are going to be with him in the name of Jesus Christ. And abundantly, oh, mighty Father.
I know that I am choosing specifically to pray for people. It's the Lord that has directed me. Let's pray for Pastor Matthew. Let's pray for his wife. Let's pray for his children. It has never been easy leading our church. It has never been easy. I believe that there are days that he becomes weary. He becomes tired. But Father, let's pray. And let us also thank God for his life. Let us not only pray that our Father in heaven will strengthen him in this journey,
Amen.
But let us also thank God for the fact that he has kept him alive, he has kept him healthy, and he has said, on what soldier I am, that he continue to say, on what soldier I am for Jesus. Let's pray for
him. Amen.
Amen. Amen. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, almighty God, glorify your name. I thank you, Lord, because of all the preaching you have done. I thank you, Lord, because of what you have done. I thank you, Lord, because of what you have done. I thank you, Lord, because you never leave us alone. I thank you, Lord, because you have been assisting us in the journey. I thank you, Lord, despite the way the road is rough, your grace has continued to be sufficient. Almighty God, we glorify your name.
He has shared us for the things that you have been for him.
We thank you, Lord, because of your promise. We thank you, Lord, because of everything you have given to us. We are able to dedicate, we are able to give it to you. Oh, my Father, we worship you. We thank you, Lord, because of your grace, we continue to be more, and your mercy, we continue to be more in the name of Jesus Christ. And by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, we will not leave us alone. Your grace is
sufficient. Oh, my Father.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let us pray for believers around the world. The Bible has told us that thousands will fall on our left and thousands will fall on our right. Only that if we believe. So many are running away from the word of God. So many are becoming weary. Today people are using the word of God to cheat other people. I was talking to a brother today who has said it's now become very difficult to even do business with our brethren in the house of God. Let us pray that as our Father in heaven sent down the fire on the Pentecost day, as he sent down his Holy Spirit to anoint the 12 disciples, as he has allowed his Spirit to live with us, he allowed his Spirit to anoint all believers around the world, that he will strengthen them as we are praying today. It will be a day of Pentecost like Jesus said to his disciples. Let us pray.
Oh, my God, pray by the power of
the Pentecost around the world. There will be anointing. Anointing of power. Anointing of the Holy Spirit. Anointing of the Holy Ghost. There will be power. There will be power. There will be power on the weak. The power on the weak. And Father, even the ones that are filled with the Holy Ghost, Father, they will become even stronger. The Lord in heaven, as they pray, Father, they will heal. They will heal many as the disciples do. They will cast out demons. In the name of Jesus, Father, today we pray for strength in your house. Father, for the weary and the weak, strengthen them. Father, for the strong, Lord, in heaven, continue to uplift them. Uplift your children. Uplift your children. Uplift your children. That we will never be weary. We will never be weary. We will never be weary. We will all be soldiers. We are soldiers for you. We are soldiers for you. Father, we will march on. Father, we will march on. You spread your word. We will never be tired. We will never be tired. We will never be tired because you're not tired of us. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you for this strength. Father, we thank you for this strength. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The other day I was hearing on the radio. I was hearing on the radio that people who are volunteered to be teaching young children now that there is no gender. There is no man, there is no woman. It is the influx of the end. Influx of teaching that we do not understand. To say that there is no longer man or woman. Let us pray for our young children, that as they grow, because they are the future. I know that all the time I talk about the young people because the Lord is talking to me. The Lord is saying, remember your young people. Remember the young children. Continue to pray with them. Continue to pray for them as our fathers have prayed for us, as our beloved fathers in the generations past have prayed for us, either our biological fathers or even our fathers in the Lord. Do we know how many of our fathers in the Lord that are praying for us? Let us pray for our children. Let us pray for our children that they will not leave the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Let us pray that I pray by the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. If the power of our children, I pray by the power and the will not lead the presence of the name of Jesus. And the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Father, Lord, thank you for the fact that they are
here. Almighty Father,
Father, you are in our lives. Father, God in heaven, Father, you will never leave your word. They will never leave your word. Our children will remain under the feet of Jesus. They will never leave the feet of our Father in heaven. Lord in heaven, you use them. Father, use them. Father, use them for your word. Father, use them to be example. 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 In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I was talking to one of my brothers, and he was telling me that they enacted a law in Nigeria that churches now will have to be audited by government. I heard that even one of the churches, they said that when you are past the age of 75, that you should no longer lead the church. So they are putting lifespan on our teachers in the house of God. Let us pray that our Father in heaven will preserve. Mm-hmm. That our Father in heaven, even as he used Noah, he used Abraham. Abraham at his old age and Sarah, they gave birth to children. That our Lord in heaven will preserve. There is no age limit on his word. There is no age limit to lead us in the house of God. Let us pray that the evil thing that is coming, our Lord in heaven will stop it. Our Lord in heaven will take away that swing, the swing that is coming, the swing that is coming to take over churches. The people who are trying to control messages that are coming from the pulpit. Let us pray that our Father in heaven will help. That our Father in heaven will soften the heart of the people in government. That our Father in heaven will have mercy. Our Father in heaven will have mercy, so that they will not take away our experienced teachers, our experienced pastors, our experienced ministers in the house of God. What they are trying to do is to take away ministers, to take away believers from the house of God by putting limits. Our Lord in heaven has no limit. Let us pray. Let us pray. Let us pray that our Father will change the heart. The enemy is coming to the end of the world. The enemy is using whatever tactics to destroy the house of God, it will never prosper. Let us pray that our Father in heaven will oversee our church, will oversee our minister. And Father, whatever they are planning, will never succeed, because you have said. The gate of hell will never prevail in your house. Father God in heaven, we pray that no weapon sharpened against us will prosper. No weapon sharpened against your church will prosper. That Father will continue to prosper. But Father will continue to Father Lord in heaven, help.
Power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, the judging. Oh, mighty Father, you will find.
Because you love us. Because you love us. Take away the hands of the enemy from the house. Let us pray for our brethren. Because now they're trying to use our brethren divide and conquer. They're trying to use our brethren in the house of God to break us apart. You know, when when what I just said, that they said they should put time limits to pastors in the house of God, and they also said that the children of pastors in the house of God cannot lead those churches. Who says that, who decides? Is it us that is left for us to decide? God can choose whoever he wants. And some of our brethren are even supporting that. They're supporting the fact that there should be regulation in the house of God. If we're allowing man to regulate the house of God, not allowing God, how can the word of God prosper? Let us pray that all those believers in the house of the Lord that are trying to support the hand of man to operate in the house of God, that our Father in heaven will arrest them like he arrested Saul that became Paul. That anyone in the house of God that is trying to put asunder our Father in heaven will arrest them. Let us pray.
Almighty Father, we pray by the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ for everybody, individual, corporate, or the devil want to use in order to against the will of the Lord in the churches. We come against it in the name of Jesus Christ, whomsoever, from wheresoever, Almighty Father, that the devil may want to use in order to disturb the plan of God for the church. We come against it in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, I pray by the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. You are supreme.
You
are the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. You are going to reign. Almighty Father, you are going to reign. King of kings, you are going to reign. Almighty Father, you are going to reign. By the power and the blood of Lord Jesus Christ.
Become ministers for you. They'll worship you.
By the power and the blood
of Lord Jesus Christ.
And you are going to reign.
Father, you've done it before. You've done it again.
Almighty Father, I pray by the power and the blood of
Lord
Jesus Christ.
You are
going to reign. Almighty Father, you are going to reign.
Father, I pray you are going to reign.
Father, I pray.
We
are
crying for you like your son deserves.
Oh, my dear Father, whatsoever, whatsoever, in any way soever, that they want to plan is your will against their will against the will of God. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. Oh, my Father, we come against it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
We pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let us pray for our district. Our district in Virginia. Let's pray for our general overseer, Pastor Kumi. Let's pray for Pastor Dada. I know that I am asking for specific people. The Lord has asked that we should pray. Let's pray for our leaders. You know, let's pray for our church members. Let's pray for families. The enemy is using their hands to destroy families in the house of God. But let's pray that the power of God will reign forever. That as we started today, as we started yesterday, that his power will continue to reign for all in us forevermore. That our Father in heaven will continue to strengthen our generations to come.
Amen.
Let us pray that the house, you know, the power of God will never depart from our house.
Amen.
You know, Abraham said that for me and my household will continue to follow our Father in heaven.
Amen.
And we decree today, let's pray today. Let's decree today that as we've all given our lives to God, that we're giving our life to God is not only as our family, our friends, our co-workers, to see as examples, that they will never depart from the house of God. That miracles will happen as we have believed that our Lord in heaven would touch all the people we have preached to, all the people we have ministered to. Let's pray this night. Let's pray this night that on Sunday we'll see them in the church. Let us pray that on Sunday our church will be filled and overflow. That there will be no space for anyone to sit. That there will be no space
for
anyone
to sit.
All the
church in the name of Jesus Christ.
We will
not remember in the name of Jesus
Christ. Because we have
all the people who
are, we don't want to go to heaven alone. Because we don't want to go to heaven alone, we have decreed today that all the people that we have preached, that we have ministered, that will come to heaven. Let's pray for turnaround. Turnaround.
Father, we revive our hearts of God.
You will bring that in the name of Jesus Christ. As you are increasing us spiritually, you are going to increase us physically in the name of Jesus Christ. Your name is good. Your name is good. Almighty Father, we are going under blood. From the north, from the south, from the west, from the east, from every area of life. Father, you will bring your new member unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. You will bring your member unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. You bring your member unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. You bring your member unto us in the name of Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Let us continue to pray for one another. And then I know by the grace of the Lord, God is going to answer our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All those people have left, not because of any other thing, just because we are preaching the truth. God is going to touch their heart. God is going to bring them back in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And everyone for that stay by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we will not miss the kingdom of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Not only us, as we are praying, we are not going to miss our leader. Our leader are not going to miss us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Also, we are not going to miss our leader in Jesus' name. And
Amen.
The grace of the Lord will be sufficient for every one of us in Jesus' name. We are
Amen.
Praying the miraculous prayer is that to see one another far away. We are praying that God will open way for Pastor Ido. He will come and visit us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Miraculously,
Amen.
God will do it in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us share the grace together. After the grace, please, I have an announcement from Pastor Ida. Let us share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
the
love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall continue to dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please, for Brother Benjamin, Pastor Dada, send the message for Sunday, both the site of scripture and the message. So check your mail. So look for the site of scripture.
Oh, the site of scripture that we'll do on Sunday.
On Sunday, yes. He sent special one.
Okay.
He sent
A copy to us.
Yes, he sent the outline.
Okay.
He sent the outline.
Okay.
Scripture. Okay. Thank you, sir, Pastor Duhu. God bless you, sir. Thank you, everybody.
God bless you, sir. Thank you, Pastor Edo. May the Lord continue to bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Good night.
You have $7.53 remaining in your account. Please enter the telephone number you wish to dial now, or press *0 to recharge and hear the main menu options.